Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our very first edition of Devotions and Issues in Focus with Shibiki Bibles. So today we are looking at lessons from the bamboo tree. One of the things I've discovered after doing some research is that the bamboo tree, when it's being planted, for years it will be down. For a second, third, fourth year, you will not see any growth. You will not even know that you planted any. I mean, besides if you the planter, that's different, but people will not know that something has been planted there necessarily. And because of that, it will just be there for the first, second, third, fourth year. Until the fifth year, it is believed that you will start seeing evidence from that there's a plant. Within 8 weeks, the plants will shoot up really, really tall. And the first principle that I can get there from that lesson is that, or from the bamboo tree rather, is that we need to be patient. So if you're planting bamboos, you need to be very patient with it. And the scripture of meditation that I found that I would like to share with us this morning is taken from the book of James chapter 5 and verse 7. And it says, James 5, 7, "Be patient, therefore, brethren, unto the coming of the Lord. Behold, the husbandman waited for the precious fruit of the earth and had long patience for it until he received the early and latter rain." This is taken from the King James Version. So when I look at it, if for the bamboo trees we have to be so, so patient, what James is admonishing us here in this scripture is that we ought to be very, very patient as it relates to the coming of the Lord. I mean, there are many times we've heard so much time that Jesus will be coming, and some persons have grown perplexed, some persons have grown with lack of concern, have developed that. But then when we look at it, the scripture says, "Behold, the husbandman waited for the precious fruit of the earth." So just like a bamboo tree planter who waits patiently to ensure that the tree grows, even if it takes years, why should we not wait? I mean, there's so many things that are happening right now around, and that so many things that really test our patience even while we're waiting on the second coming of Jesus Christ. And I love the fact of when they use the word patience, it means to be of a long spirit, not to lose heart. And well, husbandman in this sense, of course, it refers to the farmer. So I'm saying to somebody today, you may not be an actual farmer planting a tree, but then there are things in your life that you feel as if they're not coming to fruition. You feel as if you want to lose hope, you want to give up. There is coronavirus, there's so many things that is happening around. But let's just take the first principle that I shared with you here with the bamboo tree. Be patient. Just like how the bamboo tree planters wait until 4 or 5 years, whatever you may be wanting, whatever you may want this morning, I'm saying to you, God knows what you need. Perhaps it's that husband that you're waiting for, perhaps it's that wife, perhaps it's that job. What about the children? Your children are so rebellious, but you're waiting patiently for them to be better children. Whatever it is that you're waiting for, whether it be that dream, that goal, that accomplishment, that business that has not seemed to be blooming, I want to encourage you this morning, wait patiently. Just like how as Christians we are waiting for Jesus to return soon, I hope, because I'm fed up with all of these things that are going on right now. But nevertheless, let us be encouraged by this wonderful bamboo tree, and at the end of the day, that each and every one of us, that we don't lose faith, but that we remain steadfast, we remain immovable. So just want to pray for us this morning that God will help us to be patient. Loving Jesus, we thank you for another day. I pray, Lord, that you will help us all to be patient in everything that we do. May we look to you. I know, Lord, we're preparing for the second coming of Jesus, and I mean, so many things seem to be amiss, and it's like, while we know the signs, there's still, Lord, we lack so much patience. So I pray, Lord, that your Holy Spirit will guide us and continue to direct our pathways. Through Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. May God bless you all, and do have a wonderful day. Just remember, James 5:7, be patient. God's prayer. God bless you.